So, how do both our opening players feel this morning about their first matchup for Hotman Cup 13?
I haven't played her in a long time, so I think I remember played her Wimbledon like second or third round. That was like a couple of years ago, but I just have to play my game and just be aggressive and, attack.
It's very, very good because, like, it's hardly to play, to have a chance to play number one in the world. And, you know, I just go out and have some fun and play my best.
She was so popular last year, Tamarine Tanasugarn, making the final after having to qualify in the first instance. They have played just the once 2 years ago at Wimbledon. Hingis the winner. Let's cross to our commentary team now. Fred Stolle, Louise Fleming and Steve Rebilliard.
So under the Burswood Dome in Perth, Western Australia, Hotman Cup 13. Big welcome and season's greetings to all our viewers right around the country and around the world. Special welcome to our viewers in Thailand through UBC and in Switzerland through SRG. The Swiss, they are the top seeds. They're making their eighth appearance here, taking on Thailand first up. The Thais capable of anything, it would seem, judging by last year's run from the playoff all the way to the final. But a big hurdle first up with world number one, Martina Hingis, playing her fourth Hotman Cup. She's yet to win it, but my word, she's in great form, having won nine tournaments in the past 12 months. She's 20 years old, Trubach, near the Austrian border. Martina took out four of the last five tournaments she played this year to resume the number one ranking. Of course, she's won five Grand Slam singles titles and will be looking for more in 2001. And her opponent today, Tamarine Tanasugarn, is 23. She holds dual citizenship with Thailand and the USA, but she lives in Bangkok. She's had a solid year, pushing her ranking into the top 30. Started with a finals appearance here last January in the Hopman. She was also a finalist in Birmingham, made the semis of the Japan Open. She was also in the final at Junior Wimbledon back in 1995. And we welcome back to the Hopman, Jane Harvey. Missed it last year, but she's been here for all but two, I think, of the 13 Hopman Cups so far. And mild conditions by Perth standards for summer. And very much ideal for good tennis inside the dome. And Louise Fleming joins us. And Louise, Martina looks pretty fit.
She looks great. But I think if there was a time to ever play Martina Hingis, I'd be pretty happy to play her coming from like a break or a holiday rather than a 100-match winning streak or something like that, Steve. So I'm sure that Tamarine is going to be, just going out there playing one shot at a time and really going for it this match. She had a great time last year, so maybe she'll be feeling that, you know, this is kind of home court for her here.
And good crowd in, just 23 degrees. Well, it's perfect, isn't it? Humidity not too high. Fred Stolle's enjoying it up here with us. And Fred,
your
voice is not quite what it could be. It's on the mend. But well, sure, Tamarine probably sees this as an opportunity, doesn't she, as much as a challenge?
Most definitely. And it's really a dream come true. This is going back live, as we said, to Thailand. And if you look back just to 12 months ago, tennis was not a big sport in Thailand. And these two put it on the map, as to speak, and they got through the qualifying and through to the finals of the Hotman Cup last year. This year, it's different. There's a lot more expectations, I think. And just watching the two of them hit up, it's just like it's a mirror image, pretty much. They both close the face of the racket on the forehand side when they go back. Tanasugarn on the backhand side, not so much as Hingis on the two-handed backhand side. So this is going to be an interesting one, as Louise mentioned. Best time to play Martina is when she said, hey, I've been working very hard for the last 3 weeks. I want to get out there and play some matches. But she hasn't played any matches for the last month or so. And now Tanasugarn is going to come through to her. And we all know that when you haven't played a lot of matches, practice is not the same.
That's Tamarine's dad, Virachai. He was here last year. And former elite basketballer. And so good sporting pedigree in the Tanasugarn family. She'll need to draw on all of that today to match it with Martina Hingis.
Hingis says this is a perfect warm-up for her. That's why she loves Perth. She loves the Hotman Cup. And there's Mum, who's been her coach for all those years, except that
one week at Wimbledon,
which
everybody's read about.
Switzerland won the spin and chose to serve.
But to come here and play, get some good matches starting off the season, and then they go from here to Sydney and on the rebound ace surface. She has been practicing on that surface in Florida the last few weeks, and by her own statements is that I'm ready to play some matches.
Time.
I was speaking to her and she said she'd been down on holidays in the Bahamas and been doing a bit of travelling and taking it easy, kicking back, but I think she's been doing a lot of physical work, it looks like. She's really trimmed up and looks like she's in great shape.
Looks very fit, Louise, doesn't she? And I think that that's something that she really has to work on. If you look at the matches that she has, the players that she has trouble with, it's the big hitters. I still think that Hingis is the best thinker on the court. I feel that her tactics are better than anybody else out there. She knows where the ball is. She moves onto the forehand very well. But she's been beaten by the players that just overpower her. And she's got to get a little bit stronger.
Well, you got one long sleeve and one short. What's happened there? It's an interesting look.
That is an interesting look. I haven't seen that one before. I'm sure it's to keep her right arm warm until it gets warmed up. And
gee, you guys are into fashion, Steve. I didn't know you were into fashion.
Well,
I
saw this
very well.
Well, I saw the look on Louise's face. And I thought, okay, we got one long, one short.
Maybe Martina was ironing her outfit this morning and just went a little heavy on the left side and thought, oh.
I did read something about that. It's a new look for the Australian through the sponsor that she has there. And again, I guess it is to keep that right arm warm. But she looks very trimmed down, and let's see how much extra she's got on that serve.
15 love.
Well, you do put your sponsors on your sleeve, and she might be thinking if she has a longer sleeve, she can put more sponsors on there.
Well,
just a couple of opening serves in the 120 Ks. Maybe she can wind it up as the match progresses.
40 love.
Sure, Tamarine's going to be feeling a little anxious, so she can just settle down as quick as she can into the match.
That's good. That's a settler.
40-15.
Yeah, it's good to get that first one on the board when you have a shot at a passing shot. Pretty impressive serving, though. Four first serves in from Hingis.
Game Switzerland.
So Hingis drops just the 1 point in taking the opening first service game. And, well, the one short, one long is doing the business so far.
And as you can see, you don't
sit down after that first game.
Tamarine,
and
Tanis,
really, who needs to sit down after those quick 10 seconds?
Exactly.
That's a great shot by Tammy, and I think we'll see that a lot. She really likes to fade that forehand out to the backhand there. She'll use the angles as much as she can today. Oh, great shot. Tanis Agan, excellent rally with court coverage from both players. Had to pull out something special to win it.
30 love.
Well, that was great because you can see this forehand here by Martina. She goes, well, that one went down the line, but she really started the point off. Great shot there by Tamarine. She started that point off with a wide forehand, and Tammy actually really ripped one back shoulder, and it kind of put her out of the point a little bit.
That's well played.
That volley was low to her feet, wasn't it, Fred? It to be good.
Well, there's a huge crowd here at the Burswood Dome for this one, and it's the number one seed, Switzerland, against the runners-up from last year. Look, that one gets down low, with a good firm wrist, two-handed volley, that one into the corner. Both players starting well in their opening service games.
Go! 40-15.
And Tennis Agan also just drops the 1 point in holding serve.
One game.
That was a smart serve, that one, at 40-15. She's been going down the middle, trying to go for the big serve. That was just a slider out wide to the forehand, and it caught Hingis right out wide. Had to go for the winner.
15 love.
These players have met just the once before, Wimbledon, 1998. Hingis prevailing 6-3, 6-2 in the fourth round.
So deep, both players just matching stroke for stroke. 15
all.
Martina Hingis really looks a picture of health and fitness at the moment, doesn't she?
She does, but Tennis Agan is just thriving on the pace of shot at the moment.
Hingis at the net, as 30, good as 15. Anybody there.
I think that's something that you're going to see a little bit more of. This is the shot I love to watch. Comes in, makes that volley, but before that, the forehand approach. It's the easy one, the second one.
Well, Hingis can only watch that sail by.
30 all.
Well, we talked about Hingis, the way she runs onto her forehand. Tennis Agan has done a terrific job so far. A couple of forehands down there, deep into the corner of the court.
Takes a couple of games to feel their way and get the tempo 40, playing against a player like Martina Hingis, but it looks like Tamarine has really come straight out of the gate. She's looks very calm, very relaxed, and she's doing exactly what she should be doing right now.
Game Switzerland.
Hingis 2-1 on serve, but now she's got a match on her hands here with Tennis Agan starting, well, swinging pretty freely, knowing there's not much to lose, playing world number one. She's probably carried the right attitude out there.
Well, last year she said that she was having problems with her movement and her fitness, but it's very obvious that she's worked a lot on that this year. Really looking at the two differences, the main differences, I think, with the players is that perhaps Martina gets a little bit more topspin. Temmie seems to hit the ball a little bit flatter. But as you can see, they're both really getting their weight into the ball and moving very well. Martina just displaying her open stance on the backhand. Changes her grip around quite a lot and gets a lot of rip on that. But both players really moving extremely well.
You get a good idea of just the backhands, how they close the face of the racket on the backhand with Hingis.
and Tanner Sagan a little bit flatter, as you mentioned, not with as much topspin.
I think Tamarine's favourite shot would be the backhand down the line. She opens it up very well and just disguises it. You really can't tell if it's going down the line or if she's going to close it at the last minute and rip it cross court. So I think we'll see that as a little bit of a weapon.
They've had three or four terrific rallies so far in this that both players, we talk about the abilities and you think that Tanner Sagan is just a miniature Hingis, but as far as she has the same weapons but doesn't have quite as much pace of shot or the experience.
Love 15.
I think what Martina has so well, she's so deceptive, but she reads the play so well. She's always in the right part of the court at the right time.
Love 30.
I think she thinks the points through, Louise, also. She has an idea of if she's going to play a certain pattern to the shot, she knows where to go to pick the percentage of the return up. Bit of a chance now, love 30.
Oh, it's on the line.
Love 40.
And Tanner Sagan is in some bother now. Just out, and that is the first break of serve. In fact, Hingis breaks Tanner Sagan to love.
Switzerland leads 3-1.
3-1.
Some of the Swiss fans there. The young lady, it took a while to do that. I hate to try and get that off.
We're going to do that to you later this week, Craig. Oh. We'll do the whole body, though.
We got that much paint?
I really love how Martina Hingis can just generate her foot speed to move into the ball so quickly, and within two steps she's at the net. As you can see here, that quick step moves in, takes the ball very early, really controlled well.
Oh, yes, Tanner Sagan rips one off the forehand
15.
Wing. Came back with interest.
Yeah. 30-15.
I think these first few games have shown us that what Hingis was talking about. She's been working on a few things. She broke serve by attacking 2 second serves down the line. That's looking down the line a little bit further. That's what she has to do against the big hitters. Every time there's a second serve, she's got to take that opportunity, because when she loses to those players, it's because she can't start and control the point off that second serve. And the other girls are better athletes, and they hit the ball a lot harder, and they take control of the point.
Short ball, and she could take a pick there, Hingis.
40-30.
A future tennis player, perhaps. Another big return from Tanner Sagan.
And I think that's good to see her do some of that early on, because it puts a little bit of pressure on Martina's serve, and that's, I think, why we got the double fault 2 points ago. Just makes Martina think, well, I've got to put in a good serve or the delivery's going to be pretty big.
Varnish, Switzerland.
Shot was not good, and Tennis again knows she should have done better. But it's 4-1 to Hingis.
Switzerland leads 4-1.
She got away with something there. Hingis? She knows it too.
I think she likes to try all her shots out early on in the match just to see what the effect will be, and if Tammy's going to pick the ball up quickly when she sees it's a drop shot, how quick she can move. She likes to really feel her opponents out very quickly on.
Martina Hingis serve, Fred?
Yes, I think she's got to get a little bit more acceleration at the top of the swing here. You know, we can just pretty much see that going through, a beautiful slow motion shot. But if she's got to trouble the top girls, I mean the big hitters, the big servers, she gets good extension on it, but there's not a lot of acceleration on the top of that. And that's where she moves and gets the weight going forward. And this is where most of the serves have landed. So she's gone down the middle most of the time, gone to the backhand on most occasions with first serves. And I think that's something that she's really got to work on. Even from the time she was a junior, when she was winning all these tournaments a few years ago, Mum said, well, we haven't really done anything to her on the serve because we're waiting for her to get a little bit stronger and develop a little bit more. And I think that's an area where she now has to concentrate.
So one double fault so far for Hingis, the only one in the match. Tennis again to serve at 1-4.
Good lesson for you folks at home. Just watch the motion on the Tennis again serve. She doesn't get any weight on that back foot, and so therefore that's where she has a few problems. She takes that. It doesn't move back the weight at all, just stands there, throws the ball up, and it goes forward basically with the arm. You can see that right foot is just about staying steady behind the left one when it's planted there. And that's what happens when you don't get a decent serve in, and the reason for that is there's no body weight going into that serve, and it just gets dealt with.
She must have had a timing problem at some point, do you
yeah.
think, Fred? Because I'm sure she used to rock back a little bit more than that in past years, so she's just changed it a fraction.
There's nothing carrying her into the court.
There's nothing there. It's just all arm.
Love 40.
And that's where the problems come in. She realizes that with a weak second serve, it's going to be hit, dealt with severely, and that's what Hingis has been working on. So then you go for a little bit too much, a couple of double faults creep in. So she hasn't won a point now in the last two service games. She lost the last service game to Love, and it's Love 40 now.
Game Switzerland.
And Hingis romps out to a
5-1
lead.
To one.
It's unfortunate for Temerin because even though the score says 5-1, the way that she's lost the games have been, well, quite close, but she seems like she's not getting enough room, perhaps over the court, giving herself enough margin for error. So every time she's missing, it's a line or a net.
Wow, that's good. That's clean down the line from Tennis again, and needs more of those. Showed a willingness to attack the Hingis serve.
Yeah, I like the fact that Hingis is coming into the net and volleying. She doesn't do much with that volley and allows the pass to be made. But you're right, Louise, I was thinking the same thing. It's been a pretty good first set, but you look at the scoreboard and it's 5-1, but the first three or four games of this, there was a lot of great rallies and a lot of good stroke production.
I
think that's why Martina Hingis does have a lot of matches where she will win 6-1, 6-2, even though the match is tough, she doesn't give you anything. She doesn't make many errors. She's always there. She plays the right shot. She's such a tough competitor. She's placing that volley really well now.
40-15.
Couple of set points. That's why she's such a great doubles player also. She can serve and volley.
Game first set, Switzerland.
Hingis 6-1.
Well,
that lob from Hingis nearly hit the speaker system from the roof of the dome here. Helped get her out of trouble, and 6-1 first set in just under 20 minutes.
I think you're right, Fred, though. We're going to see a new Martina Hingis this year. She knows she's got to step up that level. If she wants to maintain the number one position in the world, if she wants to start winning a lot of Grand Slams in the next years, she needs to just gain that extra power that she's been on the receiving end, really, of the Williams at Davenports.
This is the serve we're talking about. Look, there's no weight coming through. There's a little bit of a knee bend, not enough though, and then it's all just upper body. See the right leg still back there as she tries. See the body weight's all pretty much gone as she hooks around the top of that swing. Body weight's not going forward much at all.
She seems to bend over at the hips when she doesn't extend up and out into the court. It really folds at the centre there.
That's where Tamarine's serves have been going.
Pretty much all over the place.
Yeah, they've been a lot more varied than Martina's. None in the stands, though.
There's the footwork again. Gives you a better idea. There's the knee bend. But see, now she lifts that right heel and there's... And I would say that's a second serve, that one.
Landing behind the line, that's quite incredible.
Time.
So Tamarine Tennis again gives the fingers a stretch. Has to come out in the start of the second set and change things a little. She competed well through the first three or four games of that first set. And as Hingis can do, just took it away from her, 6-1. So start of the second, Tennis again to serve.
Love 15.
First of the match for either player.
Right in the corner. Switzerland, the number one seeds here. Hingis has won everything there is to win except the Hopman Cup. And with the Roger Federer for a partner here this week, they're the number one seeds and the bookies' favourite at 6-4, the team. I've had the pleasure of coming here for the last few years, Steve. I think this is the best field.
Oh, I think
in general
so.
That they've had. Unfortunately, Philippoussis pulled out, but I think this is the best bunch of teams that they've had here, and there's some great competition.
And Hingis really wants to win it, doesn't she, Fred? Fourth time.
Oh,
she's
yeah.
Come very close a couple of times with Mark Rosset and got a great chance this year. Switzerland did win it back in 1992. That was with Manuela Maleva-Frunier and Jakob Lasek.
They were pretty close with Rosset until he got the match point. He ran for one and missed it and put his fist through the back wall and broke his, didn't break it, but sprained his right arm. had to pull out of the Australian and everything.
Now, he wasn't too proud of that, was he?
No.
And Martina wasn't too happy. Game Switzerland.
Well, even caught having to back pedal from midcourt to Martina Hingis still
first
comes
game,
up with a winner.
Set.
Again on the changeover, the end of a set, first game. That's the ball I love. She moves on to that better than anybody in the game. But I'm sure Hingis would like one of those tennis balls with the Argyle diamonds in. I think they're one of the most beautiful trophies in the sport.
15 love.
Hingis produces her first ace.
Speaking to Tamarine today, and she was saying that she's been travelling a lot this last year by herself. Barachai's been in Thailand, starting a tennis school.
Well, it was such a great year for them last year here, and they went home and the Prime Minister called out here, and the King said, hey, you know, tennis is great in Thailand, and this match is going live there, so...
30-15.
Everybody over there probably a little bit disappointed in the first set. This is a big step up, first match of the season, and you're running up against the number one player in the world. Oh.
Well, that's a tough shot to hit from 3 metres behind the baseline to come up with 40, that power 50. And to hit an absolute winner.
Mum liked that one.
Well, Hingis has got the foot to the floor.
Switzerland leads 2-0.
She's won the last 7 games straight.
As I said at the start of the match, we were talking about it. It looked as though it was going to be a very competitive one, and there was lots of good rallies, and suddenly you just lose a little bit of confidence on the forehand side, and that's what's gone with Tamas Sagan. And again on the serve, lost 2 service games to love in that first set. That doesn't do your confidence much good. That one right off the line. Took a very quick bounce, skidded through.
Martina spends a lot of time smiling, doesn't she? I think she really enjoys just playing and competing. And perhaps the score.
When they asked her, you know, what she thought of her year last year, she says, I think it was a great year. It was the best year I've had since 1997. And it was great to win the championship in New York at the finish. You know, marvellous match that she had with Monica Seles.
She won 9 tournaments for them.
Yes, she did, yeah. But not a Grand Slam, which is the way she judges, same as Pete Sampras. Grand Slams are the big ones to win.
There was a final not played, so she shared a title with Lindsay Davenport, I think, but they don't declare it a tournament win. It's one of the states that got rained out.
That's right, she was in 13 finals.
She says that the fields are getting stronger, obviously, with the Williams sisters and Davenport and the youngsters, Dmitrieva, the young Russian lass. And Yelena Dokic. Depth in women's tennis is terrific at the moment.
And both these players kept running into the Williams sisters. Tamarine lost three times to Serena and twice to Venus in the past 12 months.
That wouldn't do too much for your confidence, would it?
No.
But she's probably had to win a couple of rounds to get to them, so that's why her ranking has gone up this year. She's got to be proud of the effort that she's put in.
And three love to Hingis. And she looks to be well on her way to another singles win here. And helping to take some pressure off partner Roger Federer. Take on Paradon Srichapan. Let's look at Tamarine Tennisagaan. Backhand.
Pretty open swing on her backhand. Occasionally, when she gets on her back foot, the face of the racket really slides open, and that's where the difference is with Martina Hingis. She really closes her wrists over, gets a little bit more spin up the back. But one shot she really loves is when she gets that left foot out wide, stays really open, and she can drive that down the line very well. Good footwork. I think that's an area where she's really improved. Tries to get it out in front as much as she can out in front of her body. So that left shoulder has a good swing through.
So into the world's top 30, Tamarine Tennisagaan, last 12 months. She had some big wins over players like Barbara Schett, Juliela Decugi and Eva Maioli. Just finding Martina Hingis a bit tough today. Well, that's why.
Well, we talked about the start of the season in the first few matches, and it's good to play Martina in an early match like this, but not if you haven't been playing too much tennis in the last 6 weeks or so either.
That's what Temi said to me. She goes, I'm kind of happy I'm playing her first round, you know. And she said, that's a good idea. And then she looked at me, she goes, isn't it? She was wanting me to say, definitely, that's the best time to play it. It was quite funny.
Yes. Oh, yeah. That's as sweet as you can hit it.
15-30. Tamarine did really well on the grass last year, this year, sorry, in Birmingham. Got to the final. There's a look at that great forehand. Well, another great forehand forcing the error there. I just think it shows that she's got a great all-round 15-40. Game.
You play on all surfaces, can't you? Yeah.
She does have great volleys when she gets into the net, too.
Couple of break points now. Oh, that's a favourite shot,
30,
too.
40.
That's where being so flat, not a great margin of error. Whereas when Hingis goes for that shot, it's a little bit more...
Juice.
It's interesting. I think Martina's changed her forehand a little bit on the deep forehand. She seems to be kind of getting more topspin, but leaning it back a little.
Well, she survived a couple of break points. Tana Sagan looking to get on the board here in the second set. Oh, I love it.
Wouldn't that be great to be able to play tennis so easy, relaxed? Look at a spot on the court and say, I'm going to hit it right there.
Ladies and gentlemen, as a courtesy to the players and other spectators,
really looks like that's
please
what
turn
she
off
does.
Your mobile telephones. Thank
she
you.
Can place it on a dime.
Jane Harvey reminding patrons, turn off those phones. Best rally of the match. Got all the shots.
Game Switzerland.
And almost inevitably won by Hingis.
Switzerland leads 4 games to 1.
Showing the speed of Martina Hingis. Covered the net very well. I like that high slice backhand that she hit up at the net. And it was Gabriella Sabatini that could hit that one really good, wasn't it, Fred?
Yep. Tana Sagan got to be a little bit disappointed there. She had a shot at 2 backhands when she had the break point. Missed both of them, one just a fraction wide and one into the tape. You don't get many opportunities when you play against the best.
Love 15.
And you can see frustration setting in. You can hear it setting in.
Well, that's too good. Got to be good on rebound ace, the drop shot option.
Yeah, this is adding insult to injury here. Second serve coming underneath the ball, just drops the head of the racket a little bit, softens the wrist.
I mean, we know she works really hard at a game, but she seems to be gifted as well. She's got a real feel for the sport. Like, she's born to play it.
You win that many Grand Slams at such a young age, and then you, that stage a few years ago, we were saying, well, who's going to come along within the next 5 or 10 years? Suddenly now she's struggling in the Grand Slams because of the power that's coming to win this game.
Switzerland.
And she breaks Tana Sagan to love and to come out and serve for the match. Martina Hingis, it's 5-love in the second.
Switzerland needs 5 games to love.
This at the age of 12, she won junior French.
Yes, I was there that year, yeah.
And she's the youngest player to win a junior Grand Slam singles title.
Well, I think at the age of 4, she was competing in little tournaments, wasn't she? She's probably, if you counted all the balls that she's hit in her life, it'd have to be millions.
This is a look at the 2 service motions. You see Tana Sagan gets down there a little earlier. It's the footwork. See the body weight going forward on the Hingis there, up there, lifts that and then goes forward. Tana Sagan just barely lifting her right heel off the ground. Hingis moving into the court. Tana Sagan still stuck behind that baseline. Sagan off the open stance. This is a good shot of the backhand side on the toes, moving from side to side. That one throws up a lob. Get back into position in the center of the court. pulled out wide again. This time she's got a chance to make a shot, go for the forehand, get back, recover into the center of the court again. This is the two-fisted backhand she goes for again, off an open stance. That's become very popular at the moment. Off that one, it used to be you had to get the other foot right around in front. Still get that shoulder turn, look at the shoulder, and then the swing through off the open stance. Very important still to get that shoulder around on both forehand and backhand. That's the drop shot that you wish you had back again.
Martina Hingis then at 5-love in the second, serving the match, and she has a 10-0 singles record at the Hopman Cup. Whoops, didn't like that.
Love 15.
That was a good return from Tanis Sagan. At her feet. Could do more than dig it up and push it long.
There's not a lot you could say, really, is there, Fred? I mean, if you're the coach sitting on the side and you're allowed to talk to your player, it's... She's not really doing too much wrong. Martina's just in control of the match.
The best shot that Tanis Sagan has hit is that one, the two-handed backhand cross-court, actually, and the one down the line is a favourite shot. She's hit one winner down the line and about three cross-court. Inga's not quite into position. She's got to get into the net a little closer, but Tanis Sagan plays a similar type of game than Hingis. Hingis is a better thinker and just a little bit more pace of shot.
Look at a second serve and three break points here. Tanis Sagan, she fighting it out. Whoosh.
15-40.
She's able to vary the game a lot more as well. Temi's very one-paced, one-tempoed. Martina can generate a lot of pace. Can still get the lob up, she can drop shot, she can get angles. She's very crafty. Her earrings.
Whoops. Yes.
They weren't the balls on the court from the serve, were they? No.
He reminds me of the Williams sisters' beads at the Australian Open. And there was a point taken away from Venus Williams. There was a couple of warnings given.
We hope Martina Hingis's earrings don't fall on the ground. There'll be diamonds everywhere.
There'll be a few people looking for them.
That's it. That's the break of serve that Tanis Sagan's been looking for. It's come late, but she's played very well in that game.
Certainly a lot more aggressive in this game, Tamarine.
Switzerland leads 5-1.
A little bit like the first couple of games that she started off the match with. And, I mean, if she can get the ball in and increase the speed.
Stopped a run of 10 games straight for Martina Hingis.
Well, the Thai team last year are really very popular here, weren't they? They came in here as the underdog. They had to qualify to get in, and they play their hearts out all the way through to the final. So the people in Perth really took to them last year, but this is a tough ask. First match this year.
So the problem is when you want to play a directing game, when you want to be in control, it's very hard when you can't get the dominating, the first shot. And Martina Hingis keeps getting that first shot. That's put you behind the ball.
Match points. Fine defensive lob to save one match point, Fred.
Change of tactics.
Game, set, match, Switzerland.
And Martina Hingis keeps intact her perfect singles record at the Hopman Cup. 11 victories, no losses, and a 6-1, 6-1 result over Tamarine Tanasugarn of Thailand. Starts a new season well.
Yes, well, Hingis not here last year. Has come back again. She loves it here in Perth at the Hopman Cup. And that last stroke just about told it all for Tanis Sagan. She hesitated going into that volley and sort of got it down around about knee high, and that wasn't going to do it. Started off this match, the first three games, Steve, as though it was going to be a pretty close contest. We saw some nice points, some good rallies, and then after losing that first service game, Tanis Sagan just sort of got very tentative.
It's a bit like Mark Twain described Wagner's music. It's better than it sounds. Well, it was better than it looked for a while for Tanasugarn. A couple of service breaks in the first set, and she took it 6-1 in 20 minutes, the whole match in just under three quarters of an hour.
She's got to be pretty happy with the performance here, the first match out. Been working hard to get in shape. You can see there, that's a one-handed backhand. She doesn't change the grip on that one. Very much a defensive pose. Then she changes back. That's, you can see the way she closes the face of the racket there, changes the grip, closes the face, comes through and out towards the target. Good movement as she gets in position again. Pretty extreme change when she goes from the forehand to the backhand. That one was into the body, so that's more of a defensive shot. That one gets back into the centre of the court as the grip change once more. That's the topspin shot that Louise was talking about, getting a little bit more air off the back foot, trying it back deep into the court. I think she'd have liked to have a little tougher match in this one, but a good start for this year's Hopman Cup for Switzerland, and they are the number one seeds, and she would love to have this Hopman Cup along with a lot of the other championships that she's had in her very young career.
So she looks fit and she's in form, and she's talking with Glenn Mitchell.
Well, Martina, it's your first serious hit out for over a month. Were you surprised by how sweetly you hit the ball today?
Well, I practiced a lot over the last 3 weeks, so I felt very good, very confident that I hope that I could maintain, you know, the winning streak here at Perth, and just the way I finished, that I would start the season over again.
Now, what about the winning streak here? Personally, you've won 11 straight singles games, but unfortunately, you're yet to actually claim the title.
Well, I mean, sometimes you just have to wait for your time, and, you know I won all the singles matches, but sometimes this is a team competition, so it takes two, you know, to win the whole thing. So, you know, this year I have a new partner, Roger Federer, which, you know, is a great friend, and we had a lot of fun, so we'll see this year.
Early days yet, but have you had a chance to talk doubles tactics with Roger?
Yeah, we hit yesterday actually, and also this morning, and we had a warm-up, so it's great to have like the colleague also around, and you know, the team effort, the team spirit is very important, especially for me. And you know, I'm just gonna watch his match and hope he does well.
Just finally, the start of a new season and a new fashion. Can you tell us a little bit about the one long sleeve and the one short?
Well, it's kind of funny because there were things we had a lot of talks, and this is the first time I'm actually testing it in a real match. So I was very excited about it, the whole thing that, you know, supports the arm, and well, we'll see how it goes outside too. But you know, so far so good. Lucky one, lucky shirt.
Certainly worked well today. Well done.
Thank you.
Might give her an interesting suntan over the years if she sticks with it playing outdoors with one long and one short, but it certainly did the business for her today. She fulfills her side of the bargain. Hingis defeating Tanasagan 6-1.